Join me as I dive into the wild predictions of the day after tomorrow and see if I can connect them to real-life climate events happening right now. The Day After Tomorrow was a film that shook audiences when it premiered back in 2004. It was an apocalyptic disaster movie that depicted catastrophic storms, devastating floods, and a world on the brink of collapse. But what's striking about this film is how it unwittingly foreshadowed many of the extreme weather events we're experiencing today. At the time of its release, the film was criticized for its over-the-top portrayal of climate chaos. But fast forward to the present, and we're seeing eerily similar scenarios unfold before our very eyes. In many ways, The Day After Tomorrow was more than just a fictional tale. It was a warning, a harbinger of what could happen if we didn't take climate change seriously. As we look back at the film's depiction of extreme weather events, it's hard not to draw parallels with our current reality. From record-breaking heatwaves to Category 5 hurricanes, we're living in a world where the norms are being rewritten before our very eyes. Let's take a closer look at the environmental challenges we're facing today that the movie attempted to highlight. One of the most pressing issues, of course, is global warming. The science is clear. Human activities are releasing unprecedented amounts of greenhouse gases into the atmosphere, leading to a rise in global temperatures. This, in turn, is triggering a cascade of extreme weather events, from droughts to floods, heat waves to blizzards. It's a vicious cycle that's only getting more intense, and we're seeing the consequences play out in real time. Take, for instance, the devastating wildfires that have ravaged entire cities and forests alike, or the Category 5 hurricanes that have left entire communities in ruins. These are not isolated incidents. They're symptoms of a larger problem, a problem that The Day After Tomorrow eerily foreshadowed. The film's portrayal of severe weather patterns is particularly striking, given how accurately it reflects our current reality. From the storm surges that inundated New York City to the tornadoes that ripped through the Midwest, it's as if the movie's scriptwriters had a crystal ball. Fast forward to today, and we're seeing the exact same patterns unfold. We're living in a world where the polar ice caps are melting at an alarming rate, where sea levels are rising, and where the very fabric of our climate is being rewoven. The movie's scenarios are reflections of current scientific predictions, and it's chilling to see how accurately they've come to pass. Take, for instance, the rising sea levels that are threatening coastal cities worldwide, or the extreme storms that are wreaking havoc on our infrastructure. These are not abstract concepts. These are real-life consequences that we're living with today. And it's precisely because we're seeing these scenarios unfold in real time that we need to take a step back and reevaluate our priorities. One pivotal scene from the movie that still resonates with me today is when the storm surge floods New York City. It's a heart-stopping moment that shows the sheer scale of destruction that climate change can unleash. What's striking about this scene is how it echoes the real-life flooding we've seen in cities around the world. From Venice to Bangkok, we're seeing the same patterns unfold. Coastal cities inundated by rising sea levels, their residents displaced, and their futures uncertain. It's a stark reminder of the urgency and potential consequences of inaction. We can't keep ignoring the warning signs. We can't keep pretending that this is someone else's problem. The Day After Tomorrow was more than just a movie. It was a clarion call to action. So, what are the key takeaways from this video? Firstly, that fiction can serve as a warning, a wake-up call to the consequences of our actions. Secondly, that climate change is not some abstract concept. It's a real-life crisis that's unfolding before our very eyes. And finally, that we need to take action, and we need to take it seriously. We can't keep pretending that this is someone else's problem. It's our collective responsibility to mitigate the effects of climate change, to adapt to its consequences, and to find solutions that work for everyone. So, what do you think? Do you think the day after tomorrow was more than just a movie? Was it a warning, a wake-up call to the consequences of our actions? Let me know in the comments below, and if you're interested in exploring more climate change solutions, be sure to check out my next video.